Hello, how do you feel when you find a vulnerability with cool filter bypass? Because I feel absolutely amazing. But today I have for you a vulnerability where four filters were bypassed to exploit XSS on Airbnb website. The vulnerability was found by Brad Bauerhaus and Ben Sadeghipour, aka Nahamsek. He also has a YouTube channel full of talks with great bug bounty hunters. And my today's video is based on a write-up from Brad's blog. The link, as always, is in the description. Enjoy! So on embeddable listing frame endpoint on Airbnb, data from parameter CTLinkIndex was reflected inside the JSON body. And the first thing that you need to know is that there is script with type application.json, and inside such tag, no JavaScript code gets executed. But if you can smuggle a closing script tag, even inside the string in the JSON, the tag gets closed, and then you can open another script tag, this time the normal one, and execute JavaScript code inside. But of course it didn't work in this case, because if it would, I wouldn't make a video about it. And let's start with bypassing XSS filter. So if you send any HTML tag in the value of the parameter, it got deleted. But if you would put a semicolon at the beginning of the parameter value, the tag would not be deleted. And one thing to notice is that previously the payload was in the JSON value, but the semicolon made the parser think that this value is ended and another key value pair is created. And likely this is what confused the XSS filter. And you might be thinking, why are they using a U tag instead of a script tag? And the reason is that if you have multiple filters present, you want to separate them and bypass them one by one. So first, you need to see if you can inject any HTML code. And for that purpose, the least dangerous tags are the best. So we have bypassed one protection and we can close the script tag, and now it's time to open another tag with our JavaScript code. But this time, web application firewall prevents us. Now, what's the difference between XSS filter and web application firewall? The former works inside the application code and it's only used in some specific places, whereas web application firewall, or WAF, is more like a plugin to the server which analyzes all the requests. And it was rather secure because it prevented the researchers from using an opening script tag. The only way it was possible to smuggle the script tag was using URL encoded null byte inside it. It got converted, but it was not a valid HTML script tag. But luckily, JavaScript code can also be executed in other places, for example, in attributes of another tags. Example of that is image tag with onError attribute that gets triggered. WAF also blocked function calls, but luckily, this could be bypassed by inserting a comment between the function name and the parentheses. So now it was time to try different HTML attributes to execute code. And up to this point, the payload was always in JSON key, but when an equal sign was sent, then everything before it was treated as the JSON key and everything after was treated as the value. So the first attribute would always be ignored by the browser because there would be no equal sign. But using forward slashes as attribute separators, it was possible to inject more than one attribute. But of course, the attributes were also blocked by the firewall. And the same bypass that did not work with the script tag now worked with the attributes because the null bytes were getting discarded, leaving valid attribute names. So finally, we have a way to smuggle arbitrary attributes. So we can send a classic image payload and it should work. But it didn't, as there was also content security policy. What is it? CSP limits what resources you can use on the website. It's an additional layer of security that helps to mitigate cross-site scripting vulnerabilities. You can define domains that you trust and you only want to execute scripts from that site. You can also tell the browser that you do not trust any inline scripts on the website and you do not want the browser to execute them. And on Airbnb, the CSP part that's interesting to us looked like this. And the SHA-256 part tells the browser that it can only execute scripts that have checksum equal to this value. And this includes both standard script tags as well as JavaScript in the attributes. And without getting deep into cryptography, we can say that it's impossible to create a script that would have a valid checksum. And if a script element could be used, it would be possible to find some bypasses to the content security policy, but previous attempts have already shown this to be a really tall order. So the XSS has to be exploited using another tag. And at the time of recording this video in 2020, Flash is being dropped by modern browsers, but back in 2017 when this report was initially submitted, Flash could be widely used to exploit XSSs or JSON CSRFs. And using an embed tag, it's possible to use SVF file to execute an action script file. This is the code that was used by the hackers. I won't go into the detail. All that's important is that this line executes JavaScript code. And finally, the alert popped up. But the web application firewall happened out to be really annoying, and the same payload sometimes worked and sometimes didn't. And this is the payload that would work every single time. And at this point, you might be thinking, what was the process of getting from one payload to another? And the truth is, in such case, the process is simply trial and error. You just have to submit many payloads and suddenly one of them works. Because in such complicated case, when the same payload one time works and one time doesn't, it's impossible to reverse engineer and understand what actually gets filtered and what doesn't. And this payload only worked in Firefox, as in Google Chrome there was XSS Auditor, which is also dropped in 2020. And after another series of payloads sent to the server, this is what worked both in Chrome and Firefox every single time. And as the site relied on those protections, the researchers managed to find 7 more occurrences of this XSS, including store ones, which of course have bigger impact. The exact amount of bounty rewarded for this report is not known. Back then, Airbnb paid $5,000 for simple stored XSS and a little less for reflected one. Here, in total, we have 8 vulnerabilities, but they have the same root cause. So my guess, the vulnerability was paid around $15,000. And that's definitely the best XSS I have ever seen. If you've enjoyed it as much as I did, or you've liked my explanation, leave a like and a subscription down below. And for now, I wish you happy hunting and goodbye.